this session is Professor Krikalobov from Omsk. The title of his lecture is Modern Trends in Upgrading of Hydrocarbons Processing Technology.
Dear Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to spend your attention on the problem concerning with the processing of the messiest raw material in the world is the hydrocarbon. I'd like to spend your attention on some items in this field. First is some actual goals of improvement of hydrocarbons processing technologies. Next is modern state of art for some basic process of hydrocarbon transformations like creating for recording. And finally, some use for future of creating. I'd like to mention the results of basic and applied research of Institute of Hydrocarbon Processing obtained in 2004-2006. Are mainly used for discussions of the items. If you're looking for the conversion of main hydrocarbon resources like petrol or and gas condensate and associated with gas, we can consider that about 90% of these hydrocarbons now converted to motor fuel. And it's about 10% to petrochemical raw materials for organic synthesis and only 3% to technical carbon and carbonaceous material. And all reactions, what we should proceed, it's just reactions of intramolecular redistribution of carbon and hydrogen. And goals of this redistribution is just to increase during processing the yield of valuable hydrocarbons products up to 95-97% in account of crude oil, just to introduce promised technologies for associated oil gas utilization, for example, transformation into valuable products, and to improve the existing technological approach for following of the request of ecological tendencies. To achieve these goals, the next investigation activities will be productive. First, of course, is to develop improved catalysts and introduce them in existing technological schema. Of course, is to develop new technological schema operated with existing catalysts. And finally, of course, is to create new approaches including design both catalysts and technological schema. Let's start from the cracking process. Here's the reactor where is about 3,000 tons of catalyst operated to the year. And of course, 1% of losing of final products is $1 million of cost. What kind of variation of cracking catalyst now exists and what we should do in the field? First of all, it's different raw materials which is used for cracking. Around them is vacuum gas oil, heavy vacuum gas oil, mazut, and different mixes of heavy products of petrol. And second, of course, direction is necessary composition of cracking product. We should look for gasoline or just for light petrol products or polyfins. And of course, we should worry about the reactor limitation. It starts from some fundamentals, it's just reactions, it's a procedure in the reactor. We should take into account that this huge amount of reactions, pathways and main reactions, because a lot of components of hydrocarbons resource, and of course a lot of different transformations with carbon and hydrogen proceeding. But if you summarize it from the some basic point of view, based on the what kind of centers or sites, catalyst sites, are responsible for the transformation, it's not so much. First of all, is primary cracking, then is like carbon-32 converted to carbon-16 molecules. It's proceed on the strong hard Lewis sites, which is usually located on so-called metrics of these cations. Then it proceeds secondary cracking, which is take on the Bronsted sites of zeolites. And in this case, it is we split molecule 16 to 6,8, we have so-called gasolination of cracking. But if you look for next stage, and we like to obtain propane and butane from cracking, we shouldn't take into account and worry about consecutive cracking on very strong constant sites on zeolite. Component of cracking catalyst is well known, and if it's rebels on such kind of composition, we should clarify or identify so-called ultra-step zeolites with low component of rare earth elements. It's for formation of active component for secondary cracking, which is responsible for final products. It's eliminate alumosilicate gel for formation of active metals for primary cracking of long chain, for instance. And so-called bound matrix aluminum hydroxide and activated bentonite genesis matrix for formation of porous structure for capillary distribution of other carbonous molecules in intercatalysts. Start from very annoying problem, this creating of vacuum benzoate to maximize benzolant yield. If you look from the balance of carbon and hydrogen, we can dream about 90-92% mass of the yield of benzoate. But now we have only 55%. If you take into account that we cannot reach, in principle, such kind of amount, like 92% of gasoline, because structure of hydrocarbon molecules, like deactylation of third hydrocarbon chains, we should be exactly sure that 65-69% of mass to be achieved during the design of more improved catalysts. And for releases from going from 75% to 90%, we should deal with or maximize or design porous structure catalyst, then regulate of matrix and zeolite acidity, and looking for new catalytic active materials. During the investigation which was done in our institute, it was just found the map or fingerprint of optimal catalyst for breaking of vacuum gasoline. Here's the map distribution, where is some sites and porous identified. We should have some micropolous of matrix for diffusion of large molecules of hydrocarbons or materials. Then also large mesoporous of amorphous aluminosilicate for primary breaking, this strong Lewis sites. And microporous and small mesoporous of ultra-striped zeolite as crystals of 0.308 micron size with strong Bronsted size. I can add more that the crystal should have a lamellar structure. Here is the table which was obtained during the comparison in real reactor, in commercial reactor, to maximize yield of gasoline during the creating of vacuum gasoline. Here the known catalyst varies, you indicate gasoline yield and gasoline octane. And figures for design catalyst and design, for design catalyst. You see that both figures is increased. It means that now the in the design base, it was this one taken into account, this product. And it's possible to go more in this field just to improve data. This concerns the maximize the polyphenic yield. He highlights that design of catalyst produced the composition which needs more low temperature than is for normal catalyst. It means that a less amount of carbon is formed during the cracking. Without losing or polyphenic yield this increasing of gasoline yield without changing of tanker number of final gasoline. If you concern for the problems which necessary to create mazut or heavy oil, it's another design of process should be productive. We need to separate in different reactor matrix type of catalyst and the active components type of catalyst. In this case, we can use some measurement mesoporous composite with strong Lewis size and nickel vanadium traps to extract very long, very heavy molecules from mesoporous and heavy oils, which contain also nickel and vanadium, and then to use this material as a feed for a reactor with breaking this fluid gas catalytic breaking system. And during this reactor, on volatile catalyst, volatile components will crack in on the regular catalyst, and very long, very heavy component of oil will crack on the matrix. Now let's to reforming, which is very huge and basic. Unit of hydrocarbon transformation. Also, several variations of reforming process exist. It's so-called reforming for production of aromatic hydrocarbons. And also, surround them is process for benzene or toluene or xylene, maximize production, or production of high-octane reformate. Also, we should worry about the aromatic containing reformate or just the low aromatic containing reformate. Also, very complex reactions and different pathways of reforming process, including such processes like isomerization, hydrogenolysis, dihydroxylation, and deoxylation, condensation, and other type of reactions. But we look on the more simple scheme, and we will operate only these sites which are responsible for such kind of transformation. We can identify only four sites which is responsible. Just so-called sites, metallic type sites, then acid type sites, and so-called paired sites, platinum, zero, acidic sites, and platinum sigma acetic size. And it was just found during the investigation that the increasing of defection of alumina crystal structure and then modification of surface defects by zirconia or titania and creation of optimal ligand surrounding of size is a real very strong way to improve the catalyst. It just to look some more atomic scheme of the active sites of reforming catalyst, we will find here just what we told platinum zero site, which is a real small crystal of platinum or alloy of platinum with uranium or tin, and so-called unique platinum site, which is very which is responsible for aromatization of the system. And this obtaining of such kind of site is need to obtain some defects on the surface, which is possible to create by introducing in alumina four valent cation. So this is some slides demonstrates that really the increasing of defectivity of alumina is stimulated or just improves the catalyst in the aromatization of a heptane in this case. And really, then the effectiveness of alumina is higher, the aromatization level of heptane is also higher. And here there is also demonstrate the reaction rate activity. This difference platinum zero and platinum sigma amount of such kind of size on the surface of finally demonstrate also that increasing of platinum, ionic platinum sites is a way to improve the activity and selectivity of reforming catalyst over to use of zirconium. Last year we have made some investigation on how we can increase the amount of ionic platinum on the alumina support and find that it's possible to do by special procedure like so-called hydrothermal synthesis. When instead of ionic exchange complexes, it's possible to obtain so-called coordinatorily grafted species. And this slide demonstrates what happens during the hydrothermal synthesis of platinum CL4, and we can reach practically no chlorine atom near platinum. And next slide demonstrates how the part of coordinatorily bounded non-disturbed complexes influence on the on the activity of platinum of these complexes. So of course we found that during the such preparation of such a kind of complexes, entry complexes has a more higher reduction temperature of absorption and lower heterogeneation activity and more high selectivity of the site performing reactions. Here there are two slides, two figures. First is if we see for yield of aromatic compounds on the complexes which is produced from chloride precursor and from hydrothermal precursor. Finally, during this investigation, it also was designed two versions of the refinery catalyst. It is known and is operated in a plant, and now it is designed, which is also now operated in plant. And you can compare that in all of these figures is better than compare with known catalyst. Another situation, of course, is if you like to increase just aromatic yield. Next table demonstrate also the design catalyst. This was special design for obtaining of aromatics. Also increase and total yield of aromatics and benzene and toluene. Now I'd like to go to some another variation of hydrocarbon processing. Which is now investigated in Institute of Hydrocarbons Processing. First of all is so-called pentaforming process. It means that we like to substitute C6 dihydrocyclization per C5 dihydrocyclization, and instead of aromatics to obtain derivatives of cyclopentane. Here just indicate how we can do it. Just we can aromatize naphthenes, which is very easy aromatized. Then to hydrogenize this benzene, for example, into cyclohexane. And then cyclohexane will be isomerized in methyl cyclopentane. And then finally aromatization of residual cyclohexane. We call this process pentaforming. In this case, we obtain, during this stage, we obtain reforming gasoline, during this stage, pentaforming gasoline with this reaction. Now, this comparative characteristic of reforming and pentaforming process, and you see that it's necessary that. Instead of one catalyst, we should load two catalysts in the case of pentaforming, and you see that we obtain the same amount or more of the gasoline there is the same about the amount or more isoalkanes, much more cyclo pentanes, and less, more, much less amount of arenes. This is about the same from octane number of ethylene. Now we understand that maybe for future pentafolding process will have some site because what system is now is proposed for obtaining of ecological pure ethylene like following the request Euro 4, Euro 5 and so on. But in this case, you need some additional plants for isomerization and alkylation. But in the case of introduction of pentaforming, we don't need the additional plants for isomerization and alkylation because we can do it in the regular reforming reactor. Just only a few thoughts about only two processes which is now oriented on application of associated oil gases and gases which is formed during the reforming. We called it the process deforming and degrading. In more detail about the deforming process, special lecture will be this next day by Professor Bailey. Just only tell that the idea just to try to introduce non-aromatized olefins, alkanes like ethane and propane butane into a gasoline type products as a result of formation of C1, and it was so called disproportionation. We go to the increasing of amount of carbon in molecule because we lost one of the carbon, it must stay molecule. In the case of degrading, we have the same. We also combine C1 with very unstable paraffins to produce the stable aromatic compounds. I'd like to mention that this process was tested in under same industrial scale, and this is under laboratory scale. Few words about the problems with technical carbon carbonaceous material production. I'd like to mention that during the last 50 years, it was nothing more doing in the understanding how the body of technical carbon formed. It is now known that, in principle, inside of carbon body, carbon particles, spheres about from 20 angstroms to 1,000 angstroms, and depend on technology and, of course, purpose. That in center of such kind of spheres, some fullerene type of carbon are situated. And, of course, a lot of another application of such kind of material, non-structured, nanostructured carbon are expected. One of them is cars and aerospace industry, energy production, electronics, constructions, materials, and so on. Another way to utilize here different heavy oil of FCC and light alkanes fractions possible to utilize in some integrated scheme with production of new types of carbon technical carbon and other type of nanostructured carbon. And so all carbon-carbonaceous composites is also very wide field of application. So another actual trends to improve hydrocarbon processing and related technologies. Of course, it's creation of metal-resistant catalyst for fluidized catalytic cracking. It's low temperature, near lower than 100 C. Skeletal isomerization of paraffins. Palladium containing catalyst for fuel production. We have activity in this field and found that palladium can be used for some of the reaction connected with processing of hydrocarbons. Solid acid alkylation, it is not closed problem, just open to design catalyst and to produce stable catalyst for practical application. oxidative desulfurization, which is a very promising technology to for deep breaking to zero the removing of sulfur from hydrocarbons, associated all gas and light alkanes for hydroprocessing, and finally furnace process for carbon black family. And thank you very much for your attention, and this is the main building of Institute of Hydrocarbon Processing, which is situated in Omsk City. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much Professor Rikalovov. I will present him this book about
but in English, your... in English, yes?
Ah, in English?
But the book
in English. Russian. In Russian. Oh. And bon appétit. Thank you.